Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Welcome to my channel. Okay, so today I'll be doing a topic that we have looked at several times, but I have not looked at it in this dimension. Okay, so a few weeks ago I showed you a filter box that actually is used to filter my pond, right? One of my ponds. And I showed you that I actually repaired it. Well, I replaced it and I included a pump within it. Before I did that, however, my water, or should I say the pond water, looked green, just like the Oscar pond that you're seeing now. And the question is being asked as to why is it that two ponds beside each other, one look clear in it and one in it you can't. Okay, let's look at the river that I'm at right now. Right, I'm getting some plants now. This river originates from a natural spring, right? The water, you cannot see the turbidity of the water, movement of the water. You're by just standing and look, you probably will have to put your hand in it and you actually feel the current moving downstream. Now, with the constant movement of the water, what I realize is that green water may exist within the pond or the aquarium, but it will not be to that extent in which the fish will actually suffer, because what happened is that all those green stuff that is within the water will be taken up by the, whether it be the filtration system or, by the filtration system, preferably a sub or a canister filter or a powerhead managed basket, right? So I've actually included a powerhead within my convict cichlid pond, whilst the base of the pond is still messy because it's due a cleaning, right? I can actually stay at the top of the pond and I can actually see what's going on at the base of the pond, right? And this is something that I think that is worth sharing, that it works out really best if you have something actually agitating the water that does not allow the algae, the green water, to settle, and then it will gradually build up and get thick, and then end up the fish suffocates, or the fish is unable to move, or the fish is stressed. So this is one of the better ways of managing the green water. Well, for some of my ponds, I do not have agitation, I do not have movement, I have plants, and what the plants does is actually it covers the water, so therefore the sun rays are actually minimized going into the water within the pond. Let me know what you think. It works for me. Let me know what you think as we try to make fish keeping a little bit more easier, not only for myself, not only for yourself, but for everyone that is involved. Thank you very much for listening. Thank you very much for watching. Have an awesome day. Leave your comments below. Bye bye for now. Bye.